USA Radio News with Wendy King.
On the House floor.
Yeas are 240, the nays are 187. The resolution is adopted.
A vote to condemn President Trump for his comments against four minority Democratic congresswomen. The president is continuing to defend his Sunday tweet in which he called the congresswomen un-American and suggested they should go back to the countries they came from.
It's what they say about our country. It's my opinion they hate our country. And that's not good.
The Democratic House resolution says it strongly condemns the president's comments, saying they're racist. It says they've legitimized an increased fear and hatred of new Americans and people of color. People are mourning the death of retired Supreme Court Justice John Paul Stevens. He died from complications of a stroke in Fort Lauderdale. Stevens was 99 years old. This is USA Radio News. Federal prosecutors won't file civil rights charges against the white New York City policeman involved in the chokehold death of a black man in 2014. USA Radio Network's Chris Barnes reports.
The African-American man, Eric Garner, died after telling the cop that he was unable to breathe. It was caught on video that went viral. U.S. Attorney for the Eastern District of New York, Richard Donahue, says they were unable to prove what the officer, Daniel Pantaleo's, intent was when he grabbed Garner in that chokehold on a street corner on Staten Island.
Even if we could prove that Officer Pantaleo's hold of Mr. Garner constituted unreasonable force, we would still have to prove beyond a reasonable doubt that Officer Pantaleo acted willfully in violation of law.
Previously, Garner's death was ruled a homicide, but a grand jury decided not to charge the officer. For USA Radio News, I'm Chris Barnes.
You're listening to USA Radio News. So where do illegal drugs that are smuggled across the U.S. border end up? USA Radio Network's Tim Berg explores the issue.
As more and more people are smuggling large quantities of drugs from Mexico into the United States, many people wonder what can be done and where all these drugs end up. J. Todd Scott is a DEA agent, and he tells me that the drugs that flow across the border from Mexico, they end up in all different parts of the United States.
Arizona, which is also where I've worked, Texas, I mean, these are gateways to the problems that we're seeing back east. You know, nowadays, you know, fentanyl and heroin problems that have become so prevalent, have been so focused on, all of that fentanyl and heroin, or most of it, you know, comes through these border regions, and that's how it gets east. And you know, the opioid crisis overall is something that I have worked both here on the border and in Kentucky, where I'm from. At the end of the day, these cartels, they're money making enterprises, and right now, unfortunately, in society, there's a lot of money to be made in drug trafficking.
After a week, he's finally been caught. Chance the Snapper, as he's known, the 5-foot male alligator who was first spotted last week in a Chicago lagoon, has been captured. The reptile is reported to be in good health. Nobody's sure how the alligator got into the Chicago lagoon in the first place. For USA Radio News, I'm Wendy King.